collection of works in the last few months, and it's really an ongoing, part of an ongoing project that I've been working on that I refer to as auto-mythography. And it's, auto-mythography is a term that I've adapted from Audre Lorde's term that she titled her book of biomythography, titled the book is called Zombie. And so the idea of an auto-mythography is that it combines personal narrative with cultural and personal mythology. Sorry, I'm nervous. And the concept, to me, really combines my two central concerns, one of self-invention as well as self-representation. And so I begin my work with photography, and so I actually, like for these works, I'm actually hanging upside down and using a remote shutter control to take photographs of myself. And the inverted head is meant to function as a signal that we're moving from a kind of conventional portraiture to a space of imagination or self-invention. And the idea of exaggerating the hair really comes out of the cultural space that hair has in the lives of Black people, and the kind of ways that it has embodied our changing ideas of standards of beauty, as well as you know, political consciousness. And so it's kind of this area that's already so weighted with personal and cultural history. So I try to develop it in a way that allows it to become this space of sort of infinite creative possibilities or generative possibilities. So it becomes a space of abstraction or, you know, imagination. And this work more specifically came about, I read a review of an exhibition by Seurat's work at the MoMA recently. And, you know, he's mostly known for his paintings and this kind of pointless technique that he's developed. But in his drawings, you can kind of see the seed of that, where he takes, just very simply using crayon and combined with the texture of the paper, to create this kind of dappled light texture effect. And so I've taken that technique but used it, you know, to create this form of black hair. So I'm trying to make this kind of equation of the drawn mark to hair texture. And this was actually the first piece before I had read that. And so I'm really using, you know, a single mark, you know, represents a single strand of hair. And then, you know, here taking it to this textured page kind of develops the form in another way. And for people who are maybe familiar with my work, you know, previous to this exhibition, or if not, I have a piece up at the MFA right across from the cafe, that you'll see that maybe there's like a bit of a movement that I've gone through from kind of self-portraiture more about resemblance to this kind of more, I mean, I guess you could call these self-portraits, but like at what point does it become something else, because the perspective on the head is so different that the head becomes a kind of form as opposed to about resemblance. So I feel like this work is more about introspection or a kind of introverted view, as opposed to sort of more about this outward resemblance. So, anybody have questions?
How do you use the photograph? So you take, how different is the document? The picture is very different from the photograph.
I just use them at, you know, really for developing the head, and then for helping kind of develop the general shape or the flow of the, you know, the rest that comes out. So I just use them as a guide, because obviously I can't see myself from these odd points of view. So, but I think that, you know, what I'm interested in is those tools that we have for self-representation, and so that embedded in the work are these multiple kind of stages of self-representation. So, yeah.
So in the painting, the last painting, mm-hmm. are you trying to replicate Seurat, the pointless with the digitalization?
Well, I'm definitely thinking about impressionism in general. And
but pixelization right. in place is pointless.
Right, mm-hmm. right.
Thank you.
Are you
concerned?
Go ahead.
No, that's all right. Do you have a concern when you think about death? I mean, because to me they're very corpse-like, mm-hmm. and there's something about the bodiness of the hair and the woman centering. It strikes me as these like sphincters and holes of the body. Mm-hmm. And I keep thinking about the body as a donut, right? This is an elaborate donut. And are you concerned with how that relates in some way to the history of Black representation, of embodiment of Black representation? That's kind of to your work.
Well, I think that's an interesting, reading and perspective on the work. I mean, I became interested in this particular point of view and the way that the figure can disappear, as opposed to here where it becomes kind of decapitated. So, almost like this positioning of this imaginative space kind of takes the place of, or becomes the body, becomes the figure. So, and feel free to come speak with me.
Again, yes, all the artists will be here to meet with them individually. We have one more artist to talk with, Emily Sloan, and her studio is just around the corner here. There may not be room in the studio, but she